What a crowd we have tonight. Heroes and adventurers. Conquerors of countless trials and myriad fiends. But such storied pasts are also stained with indelible tragedy. Memories of heroism laced with sorrow. Tonight, we forget all of that. We put our suffering behind us. And we celebrate. Melancholy is not invited to this feast, where we will reminisce and smile at our deeds. And of course, if you wish it, you may keep your eyes closed and remain here forevermore. So, I don't know you, and you don't know me. What are we all doing here, then?
Doubtless, we are here to fight. Though we have yet to make introductions.
A problem that can be easily remedied. We still have manners, after all.
Indeed. You may call me Graf. I am honored to make your acquaintance.
And what about you? Or will the masked man suffice?
Well, that's better than any name I might give you.
Thank you all for answering my invitation. The main event shall be ready shortly. In the meantime, I have prepared a little diversion to keep boredom at bay.
A diversion, huh? What exactly does that mean?
You would not want to ruin the surprise, would you? A little mystery can do wonders for the soul, and bring a little life to this party.
Oh, mystery! I wonder what it'll be!
If it is not to our liking, I take it we can leave.
Of course. But if I didn't aim to entertain, would I have invited you? Tonight's every moment has been immaculately planned, according to your proclivities. Now, right this way.
Can I ask you something? Have we met somewhere before?
Not that I can remember. I received an invitation.
What kind of invitation?
Let me guess. A fairy gave it to you. That is how I received mine.
And you didn't have anything better to do?
And you did? You are here as well, after all.
I guess you have me there.
Thank you. version that fairy was talking about?
I guess we won't know until we see what it has to show us.
Well, let's have a look then, why don't we?
Well, what are you waiting for, Koopo? Touch it! Presenting our beloved Princess Sarah! Neil!
Right.
I brought you a warrior who shows great promise, Koopo. He may be the one the prophecy speaks of. I've seen him fight, and he...
I sense it. He has managed to achieve a very great power in only a very short time.
Not bad.
Koopo! But it's not just that, Princess. He's kind, too. He saved me from a bunch of nasties. I would have been a goner for sure, Koopo. I know it, I just know it.
Then, it is as the prophecy foretold. For he shall walk with a Moogle not behind him, but at his side.
Yes, Koopo, yes! So, what do you think?
If this kind soul vows to fight for the people of this world, then the royal line of Cornelia will do all in its power to aid him. But he must choose to tread the path before him.
I do.
Then I bestow upon you the boon of House Cornelia.
Koopo, Koopo, Koopo!
I very much look forward to the day when we are met in the flesh.
Koopo. Princess Sarah is far away from here, but the crystal's magic brought her to us. It let her grant you the power of her house, Master.
What kind of power?
The power to journey to faraway places in an instant. With it, you can use the teleport stone at Castle Cornelia. Then you can travel closer to Princess Sarah, Koopo.
Teleport? That sounds familiar. All yours.
Sweet. Goodbye. Koopo, Koopo! Koopo! Koopo!
Served you right. Come on, get up. Hmm? Mog? Mog! This better not be a joke. I'll kill you myself if it is.
Prophecy, Koopo. A friend to the Warrior of Light shall sacrifice himself. Only when his life's breath reaches its end shall the key sought appear. The friend made shall be lost, but the hope given never forgotten.
What? I don't see any keys. Nobody's dying here. Huh? No.
There it is, Koopo. I was worried. If there wasn't a key, Koopo, that would mean I wasn't your friend.
No, no, no. Keep worrying. Stay with me. Come on.
My little heart's all full up. All this excitement. All this hope. That's a lot of stuff. Now, all Moguls are friends to the Warrior of Light because of me. If I wasn't the one the prophecy spoke of, then all of my hope...
Mog...
Every Moogle in Palamecia is feeling this hope right now.
They are, aren't they? But don't go splitting it up. You keep it for yourself.
I can't, Kabul. That's another law of Palamecia. I have one last favor to ask. Give us a hug, Koopa. This feeling, I'm going to keep all to myself. They'll be so jealous, Koopa.
It won't be long now.
Until?
Until we are speaking face to face. You are not far from the Citadel now.
Mog didn't make it.
Yes.
You knew?
I did. You were destined to lose a dear friend on your journey. But that loss will only serve to strengthen your resolve. It will drive you to become the Warrior of Light.
Fine, but is that all you have to say? Mog had a good heart, and he adored you.
And the last moments that he shared with you filled that heart with hope. All Moogles share their thoughts across instants. Mog's hope has been felt in the good heart of every Moogle.
So everything's all right because he died content? That's good enough for everyone? For you?
If tears of sorrow could bring Mog back, I would shed any number of them.
Would she really? I'm sorry, Your Highness. I didn't mean to...
Please, call me Sarah.
Tell me more about this prophecy, Sarah. Will I lose anyone dear to me again?
There will be paths that part and paths that cross. You are here now, are you not? You are met with me.
So what comes of our paths crossing?
I'm sorry, I mustn't say.
Mustn't say what?
Gods, what drama. Come, let us go.
And what's your role in all this? Does the prophecy mention you too?
No, I take no side here, neither good nor evil, and for that this world names me heretic. But no matter, you'd best not keep the princess waiting. I'll guide you the rest of the way. Don't worry. I have no intentions of getting myself killed for your sake. If you end up dead by the wayside, I'll just leave you and cast my lot with the next blank.
Comforting words.
What was that? You two were both there, and Sarah was inside a crystal.
No, that couldn't have been me. I would never forget something like that.
You are right. That was someone else. A fragment of a tale from another world. Their faces may resemble yours, but the similarities stop there.
So what's the point? I'll
only thought to provide you with entertainment to lift your spirits.
Lift our spirits? Whatever that was, it had the opposite effect.
I suppose I chose wrongly. Perhaps the next fragment will show us something more to your liking.
What tale is in store for us here? Let us see.
The enemy comes! I remember my name! It is Severin! Long live the princess! Long live Palamecia!
They didn't even scratch it. How do they hope to defeat it?
Do not falter! Cast aside your pride! Eternal glory awaits! Come, we hunt chaos this day! Get out of here! The same thing that happened to Bob. Do you think that stealing my friends away from me will crush my spirit? That I'll lay over and die? You've misjudged me. You haven't crushed me. But I will fight harder.
Catch up to me.
I'm Caster! I hail from Mid Castle! Princess Sarah! Witness me!
We Blanks have no memory of our past. Perhaps when we die here, We are reborn with our memories elsewhere.
What are you saying? Even if our memories do return, a pointless death is a pointless death.
Maybe so. Live long then, friend. And if you live in glory rather than die for it, then our deaths are not pointless.
Stop. What are you doing?
I am Laro of Eblin. May my light be cast on Princess Sarah! No!
You didn't have to die for me, but I will live for you.
A tragedy, and also a waste.
A waste?
To die in the name of another. At first glance, it seems a noble end, but when all is said and done, only corpses remain.
They weren't thinking about glory or nobility. They gave their lives to something they believed in. What's wasteful about that?
So, they died how they wanted. Does that alone make their death worth something? I didn't know any of those people we saw in the room. But if you ask me, it doesn't matter if they chose it or not. The loss of life is always sad and wasteful.
Yeah, but once it happens, it's final. Those left behind have to make sense of it some way or another.
Let us see if this rune can inject some life into this dull affair. No. You are to become the warrior of light. You cannot love freely. You cannot love me.
What did that prophecy say? The warrior of light will defeat chaos and take the princess as his bride.
Everyone believes in you, in the prophecy. You're our hope. You'll defeat chaos and become the warrior of light. Then, you and the princess. Everyone awaits the day when that prophecy becomes truth.
Are you waiting?
I...
People do not live for prophecies.
What?
Princess Sarah said as much. Though the prophecy gives us life, we do not live for the prophecy. Following the prophecy isn't everything. Sometimes we must turn our back on it, find a new road. I told this to her, and the princess agreed.
But if you don't follow the prophecy, how will you defeat chaos?
I have an idea, a new plan, a new way, not foretold by the prophecy.
Heretics must die. It's the law. But you're a swordsman, a good one. You could even defeat chaos. The voice says it would be a shame to kill you.
What madness is this?
It says to kill the witch instead.
I don't see any witch here.
It's her!
Listen. She has misled one who would become the Warrior of Light. She spat on the prophecy that binds the Warrior of Light and the Princess together. She's a witch, a heretic who does not honor the law. For this she must die, by your sword.
What?
There is another prophecy which says that the Warrior of Light will cut down the witch, and thereby return to the true path.
So cut her down, and you'll be a heretic no longer. You can return to the prophecy. Defeat chaos. Become the Warrior of Light.
Never!
No!
No. You wouldn't cut her, so I did it for you.
Maybe you're not the Warrior of Light the prophecy spoke of after all. Maybe you are a heretic. And all heretics must die.
We were swept away by the darkening tides, sinking deep into oblivion. Oblivion and pain, but there remained a lonely stillness in a corner of my heart. If we could not live on together in this world of Palamecia, then we would sleep in the darkness together. For an eternity. The dead may lack hope, but they are also without despair. For too long I lingered in the sunless, airless depths, marking the passage of interminable time. And when I once again opened my eyes, I was not myself. I rose as the Azure Witch, Maya, the new me. But he never rose again. What a trite tale of a broken heart. I am nothing like her.
Are you sure? Not even an inkling of sympathy for your twin?
Not at all. What sympathy would I have for such a fragile thing? She is a victim of her own foolishness.
I find these visions unpleasant as well. What meaning is there to these charades? What manner of entertainment are they meant to offer us?
Perhaps entertainment is not the goal.
Maybe that fairy is just trying to get a rise out of us. For her own sadistic pleasure.
Then let us have the truth from her. And she had best give us satisfactory answers, or I shall have to entertain myself with her screams until she does.
That got dark.
I don't want to know what this one has in store.
The sooner we humor it, the sooner it ends.
More than that to catch me off guard. Hey, what? That's a dirty trick. Huh? What?
Sorry, I'm late.
There she is. Easy pickings.
What now?
You die.
I did not expect the runes to show us.
Another trick. That wasn't me. You would never catch me being so emotional.
But the resemblance is uncanny. Still, I can say with confidence the man in this story was not me.
Or it is, and you forgot. Maybe we all did.
It is poor entertainment either way. What meaning is there to show us acting as fools? What are we meant to learn? If the stories were at least interesting, then perhaps I could understand.
Disappointing indeed. No one wants to see scene after scene of tragedy, much less when one is dreaming. It is pointless and tiring.
I agree with you guys. Whatever these runes are trying to show us, it isn't good. Let's hope things pick up.
So are we done with these sordid tales? Expected something more. Are we supposed to weep at these hackneyed melodramas? Tear out our hair and gnash our teeth?
Something went to all of that trouble to get lookalikes. What a waste.
It is a poor story indeed if I cannot empathize with my own likeness.
Were you really as unmoved as you say? The runes didn't make you feel anything? I find that a little hard to believe.
I felt boredom.
I apologize for disappointing. The suffering of another can prove as sweet as honey. To some, that is. It would seem I was mistaken about you.
Why would we relish in another's misery? What do you take us for?
Only a monster would enjoy this.
Suffering isn't meant to be remembered, to be mauled over.
Then perhaps you would prefer to forget it.
Huh?
You would? Then let me oblige. I shall help you forget everything. Every painful memory, every sad moment, every regretful decision you have ever made. I'll just wipe it all away. Start fresh, a clean slate. And what's more, your every desire will be granted. You just have to say the word, and you can live happily ever after. Forever, and ever, and ever!
Forever? Really? Anything I say, huh?
Indeed! What shall it be? A sumptuous feast? A reunion with a long-lost friend?
The second one.
A reunion? Well then, hold their memory in your heart, and shout your desire to the heavens!
Do I have to?
If you want your wish granted. No half-hearted utterance will do. You must give the performance of a lifetime!
Fine. I'll give you a performance, all right. I'll show you how to move someone to tears. No matter how long we spend apart, I'll never forget our time together. The days with you by my side, watching over me with caring eyes. The day I lost you, my heart broke. The day I find you, I'll be whole again. I wait for that time to come, alone and crestfallen. Won't you answer me when I call your name? Won't you answer me? Echo!
So it shall be. Look and behold! Your fairy friend!
Huh?
Would you look at that? Kidnapped! Whosoever will save her from this predicament. Perhaps her beloved?
Don't rub it in. I'm on it.
Then it begins. Will romance triumph above all? Or will our hero's heart remain ever broken? Love-struck hero inches ever closer to his bell. Will he make it in time?
Where is she?
You must call out. Open your heart, and the way forward will open in turn. And remember, no faking allowed.
Fine. Days pass and seasons change, and still I search. I see your face everywhere I go. My dreams of you, my only comfort. And I will march on, confident that the path I walk will lead me to you, my love.
Thank you.
covered
somewhere.
Journey of ardor, an adventure, of danger and desire. We are here. Your beloved lies entrapped within this very tower. However, there is one final obstacle to overcome. One final profession you must make.
I already said my piece. Let's end this.
There is no end if you do not light a fire in our hearts.
Tremble in fear, for I will cut down any who stand between me and my beloved. Your demise is at hand.
Love triumphs over all! Thanks to your bravery, our captive fairy has been set free from her terrible fate.
We are reunited at last.
Wait, what are you?
The world itself moved to see us together. Every day apart from you was an eternity, an endless despair. But I knew we'd meet again, even during my darkest days.
Are you alright? Are you being mind controlled?
Now take my hand, and let us make up for the time that was stolen from us. We have the rest of our lives together.
A what? No, this must be a nightmare! Wake me up!
Cold feet. How typical.
What a turn.
Perhaps we should mediate.
We'd probably just make it worse.
What? Oh no, come back!
Thank you.
did you think I would react?
Sorry, I had to. There was no way to get you out of there otherwise.
I suppose. And it looks like I wasn't the only one left speechless.
I've been trying to figure that out, too. Everyone besides me seems to have forgotten who they are. All I know is that other fairy called us here. Do you know anything about it?
All I know is that when I came to, I was locked up in that room with no way to get out. Didn't even get to choose my dress. This is definitely not my style.
So, you were faking. This whole time you had me tricked. I thought the spell worked. I was fooled. Anyone who read the invitation should have awakened a whole new person.
I threw it away without opening it. Why would I look at something fairy sent me?
Rude.
Once I saw how the others were acting, it was easy enough to play along. I think I deserve an explanation. Why are we all here?
That answer is simple. I only wanted to see your wishes come true.
Then why didn't you start by asking us what we wanted?
You know better than anyone that people can rarely express their deepest desires, no matter how hard they try. Their embarrassment and their shame prevents them from saying the very words that would make them happiest. So I helped things along a little. I took away all the baggage that would stop them, to let them express themselves to their heart's content. Perhaps you should consider joining them in their candor. Forget yourself and find ecstasy in your ignorance.
matter? Let your guard down?
I only wanted you all to be happy. To forget the trials and tribulations that plague Palamecia. And to take your mind off the hardships yet to come. The least I could do was rescue you from reality's cruel embrace and bring you joy. And then perhaps you would choose to turn your back on your past and stay in this dream forever.
I see. So there was a purpose to all of this.
If her words are to be trusted, then her intent was not altogether malicious.
Maybe, but I could have done without all my memories being taken away.
I must say, I agree with Sophie's sentiment.
Okay.
Then shall we simply begin again? Perhaps our host wishes to make amends somehow.
Amends? Yes, well, an apology?
We don't want an apology. You promised us a party, didn't you?
You did wish for our happiness, did you not? What better way to ensure that than to send us off in grand fashion?
That sounds splendid. I am sure Echo is eager to serve once again.
Of course I am. If you would come right this way. Well, it looks like we might have a good time after all. A good time we'll forget once we wake up.
So? Doesn't mean we shouldn't enjoy it while we can.
I know, but don't you feel even a little sad? Isn't there anything from this night you'd like to remember?
Nope, not a single thing.
Not even your little serenades? Oh, boo-hoo! Where is my beloved? Oh, did I hit a sore spot? I did! Who knew you could be so passionate? I bet you're cringing right now remembering it. I'm never gonna let you forget. Not in a million, million years.
Go ahead. Remember it if you can. Everything I said, it was the truth.
Huh? What?
Heh. Gotcha.
You... Why, I never... Why did you call me here?
Can't honestly remember.
What if we never meet again?
We will.
I hope so. Gonna make me wait?
Not that long.
I'll hold you to that.
I'm sure you will.